Hey Carl, coming back to you. This is the second hunting video I'm gonna make. This is the second weekend of hunting season, gun season in Ocala Pipeline. It's the evening hunt. After work on Friday, and I'm just going to. It's been raining a little bit. The wind is coming out of the northeast at about 7 miles an hour. The deer forecast is saying that it's really good evening. So I'm hoping for something good, maybe to put some pork or some deer on the ground. So I'm gonna get out, go ahead and get in here. Got about a 400 yard walk. I'm going in blind to an area that looked good from the air. There's a lot of diversity and stuff like that. So we'll see what happens. Stay tuned. Clouds moved in. And I was just getting ready to get dumped on a little bit, but I cleared up pretty quick. Wasn't that bad. Only lasted about 20 seconds. Now, what you can't hear is that off to my right, when I was rattling, I believe it was a couple of does came in. Now, I've seen them does before scouting. I've had them blow at me and stuff like that. So just to say, for those interested, we might be getting to the rut here and around Ocala Pipeline because they did call in. I just couldn't get them into visual sight. I only could see like 40 yards here. Rattled because I thought I was all alone out here tonight. Last weekend I was in the evening. A guy yelled out, "I hear something. Release the dogs." So now they just release dogs. So it should be interesting. Dogs got close once or twice, but they didn't come through. But the squirrel did find me and created a ruckus for about 20 minutes, the last few minutes of daylight. Well, that's going to put a wrap on 11:20 Friday. So to cap the night, I'm sitting on the ground, obviously, so I can't see more than 40 yards or so. I believe I'm pretty sure, because it's pine needles, I had a couple deer go off to my right. Sounded like footsteps. Probably was a couple does. I've seen does come out of this bedding area before. And so it probably was them, but hopefully if you find the does, you may find the bucks. Thank you. Let's get at it tomorrow morning. Hey, so it's Saturday morning, November 21st. Just getting ready to go in the woods. It's 6:02 in the morning. I'm already at my spot. I just gotta walk in. About a 400 yard walk. So yeah, I'm gonna go back to that same spot that I was at yesterday, last night, where those does were. That large bedding area is, and there's like a, I didn't show you this part, but there's like a really open part. It's got some palmettos and it's got some oak trees and stuff like that. My guess is that for one, I can shoot probably 200 yards in there. And number two, if the bucks and does start cruising, they may run through there on their loops. So I'm hoping that this will turn out well. Stay tuned. The wind's coming out of the northeast about 12 miles an hour. And it's about 63 degrees outside. It's going to warm up to about 76. Partly cloudy and small chance of rain. It's actually drizzling on and off. So perfect deer weather. The forecast for the deer this morning from Drury Outdoors app is very good. So yeah, let's see what happens. All right, see you in the woods. This is about the earliest I get into the woods in Ocala. I don't want to walk up on a bear in the darkness. And so it's about 6:24 right here. Call, but it's perfect for a bear spray, so that's what I like. I don't want to shoot no bear, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, nothing came to the call. I didn't hear nothing, you know, breaking sticks or crashes in the woods, nothing like that. I'm not sure this was a good area right here. I probably won't hunt this area again. So, now to move on to the next spot. I decided to move about 8 o'clock. This is the second spot here I found this morning. I found this old stand. It's got a couple of rungs broke. Well, one rung broke on it, and it's bent down at the bottom. Hey, let me know in the comments below whether or not it's fair or right to take it down. It's probably been sitting there 5 years. Let me know. My heart's instinct is don't touch it. I sat here about an hour, and then I decided I would get up and look around a little bit to find a good spot for my blind, and made a mock scrape, peed in it, hopefully to get the bucks, you know, in that area interested. Not 100% sure I'll be back tonight, but hopefully so. Alright, so to recap the morning hunt, I went to a spot where I could shoot probably 200, 250 yards. Didn't really see anything. They let dogs loose, and they came close a couple times, but, you know, not close enough where I could see them. I do want to see them sometime. That'd be pretty cool. They came pretty close, but nothing ran across. By 8 o'clock, I decided to change locations. And so I walked another maybe 200, 250 yards. Down the logging road until I hit a swamp. When I got to the swamp, I could hear something moving through the water. So I hurry up, sat down, didn't even find a spot very, you know, with a lot of cover, because I was just hoping to get a quick shot off, you know. But so I sat down and I got settled in, and I called and I rattled, and then I heard something sloshing through the water. It was a deer, most likely. Sloshing through the water, and that's when I turned on the camera and I said, there's something over there. But I never seen it. You know, again, you know, the farthest I can shoot is 35 yards. There is small trees and brush everywhere. So this evening, hopefully I'm going to go in there. I found a spot a little bit to the left of that. It's in the water for the most part, but I can shoot 50 yards. Now I'm shooting a Savage Model 11 Hog Hunter, and it's got the 110 twist, so I have to shoot heavy bullets through it in order to be accurate, and I want to be accurate when I shoot. So I shoot about 180 grain bullet, so hopefully if I shoot one of these Florida bucks and I make a good shot, I'll drop it in its tracks, because I don't want to track it through the water. That would be very difficult, especially at nighttime. But yeah, that's where I'm at. That was the morning hunt. And thank you. I'll see you guys tonight, hopefully. All right, I got my favorite hunter with me today. We're back in the same spot I was in this morning. I'm at the part where I can shoot 50 yards through the swamp. If it does happen, I'm hoping we drop the deer, because it's not the best swamp around here. But stay tuned. Wind's coming out of the northeast, I believe, and about 76 degrees. But it should be a beautiful. It's getting ready to rain, and it did indeed rain. We had to leave early because of that. But what sucked is, as soon as we got packed up, it stopped raining. Alright, that wraps up the evening. I don't know if I'm going to hunt Sunday after church or not. I don't know if I'll be able to get out there. But it started raining, which was no problem. But then it started raining real hard, and then we decided to come back. We got all our stuff packed up, and then it stopped raining. So at that point, I was like, well, let's just go ahead and go. I mean, I got everything packed up. So it's 5:32 now. It's almost quitting time. So didn't have any sign of deer whatsoever this evening. I mean, I don't know what happened. Anyway, that's my video. And hopefully I get a chance to hunt more this weekend. But if not, it was fun. I enjoyed it. Have a good day.
Hop out the whip, that's a two-seater. Hop out the whip, that's a two-seater. I ain't got a Lambo when I've been stupid. Mercedes in my garage. Yeah.